We all know that we should have to be out here. We should not have to go on strike for safe staffing. That's something that should be a regulation, should be a law. There's no reason why it doesn't already exist. Workers shouldn't have to come out on the picket line in order to get safe staffing, something that should be a basic function of government. But we're here and we're going to keep doing it until we don't have to do it anymore, until we win safe staffing. Right?
Yes.
What do we want?
Safe staffing.
They can't hear you. What do we want?
Safe staffing.
When do we want it?
Now.
What do we want?
Safe staffing.
When do we want it?
Now.
Next, I'd like to welcome our Executive Vice President and leader here in Rhode Island of SEIU 1199, Patrick Quinn.
How many of you been doing this work for 5 years? Raise your hand. 5 years. 5 years or more. 10 years or more. There's got to be some people hiding somewhere. Dave, how long you been a nurse? 45 years. How many?
More than 15.
You started when you were 15, right? Listen up, Bannister. And many of you have been here a very long time, and Bannister has always been a leader. Always. That, as we said all the time, the place wouldn't even be here if it wasn't for us and the union. As a union, we fought to keep it open. As a union, we fought to serve the community. As a union, we've tried to make the state understand that it's wrong to say you can pay black and brown people less money, because that's what this is about. This is public money. Everybody here should make a decent living in 40 hours and not have to work two or three jobs. And we found out through the pandemic how much of a standard that actually was, and standard is not the right word, how much of a dangerous situation that was, because people have to work multiple jobs to survive, or have to work a lot of hours to survive. And that's wrong. That's absolutely wrong, and it needs to get fixed. And we need to figure out this staffing question, because it has nothing to do with the pandemic. The pandemic has only brought it to light. The staffing situation in nursing homes has been horrible for a long time. Everybody understands that, right?
Yes.
We've been working short constantly. Yes. It's an intolerable situation that's gone on too long, and this pandemic has brought it to the fore, but it was there before.
Yes.
So we need to stay the course, and Bannister needs to be the leader that it's always been, in all of our union shops, in all of our union places, because we've been one of the first places to organize along with Parkview many, many years ago, probably in the 70s. So this building, this organization, this group of workers has a really special mission, not only to take care of people, but also to lead on producing better outcomes for patients and for workers. And I'm so proud of all of you that you're ready to take on that fight. We ready to win?
Yeah!
Ready to win?
Yeah!
You fired up?
Can't take it no more.
All right! Good job, everybody. Thank you all who are here.
Nope. Go with the music. I'm going to lose my voice, so go with the music.